Welcome to the Great Exodus Series, God's plan of rescue for the church. Let my people go, the path to Mount Zion. My name is Michael and I am the founder of Triple Grace and the Righteous Path Movement Foundation. And today we will talk about the biblical plagues that have destroyed Egypt and that made the way for the Israelites to move out of Egypt. 10 plagues that asserted at the end the Pharaoh so that he let his people go. The people of the Lord moved out of Egypt. Now, the plagues are different kinds: lice, frogs, hail, darkness, death of the firstborn, and so on. Now, since 2017, we have seen a lot of these biblical plagues showing forth in this world. And I'm not joking, just make a Google search about this and you will see that since 2017, we have a heap of such plagues, red water appearing in some countries and in some continents, water looking like blood. Then we have lice infestations, we have frogs somewhere, and the latest of the one was a locust flood in Mecca. That was just recently. And do you know what happens after the locust flood in the biblical plagues? What was the next plague? The next plague was a plague of darkness. Thick darkness was on earth, thick darkness that will cover this world. And I believe that this darkness will be related to the raising of the dead. And the dead will come out of the grave just before the escape of the bride. So this is the next biblical plague that you will see. Darkness. If it's 3 days of darkness or only hours of darkness, I do not know. But this will be the timing. It will be now the next biblical plague that we will see. And after that biblical plague comes the last plague. The last plague was the death of the firstborn. Now, of course, you will ask me, how is it possible that there will be the firstborn? Firstborn will die. No, they will not die. There will be a pattern to it. And what pattern will be there? What pattern will you see? But that will be similar to the death of the firstborn. And I believe that is the escape. The escape of the bride. When children will be raptured out of the womb of the mothers, not yet born. When children and the matrons, their mothers, will be taken to heaven. When people will disappear. Many of them may be firstborn, but I believe that the firstborn relates here in this case to the first fruits. The first fruits of the harvest will go. The firstborn of the harvest will go. They will just disappear. This is not a rapture, this is an escape. The people will disappear. And this will be then similar to people have died, like the last plague in Egypt. And when this has happened, and the great escape of the bride has taken place, then what follows afterwards is us moving out of Babylon. If you're not part of that escape of the bride, and there will be many who think that they are part now, who will not be part of the bride, and they will still remain. But don't worry, then we will move out of Babylon, out of the world, and we move towards Mount Zion, because then we will go in the next great harvest with a multitude of people clothed in white, in the rapture to paradise, the rapture of the church. So do not be afraid. But these biblical plagues have started in 2017 and maybe even before that, but they're coming to a close now. We have only 2 biblical plagues left, and the time of darkness can be come over us very quickly. It's maybe the death, I think. And then the escape of the bride will take place. There's no time left. I ask you, join us. Get prepared to move out of the world and out of Babylon. It is your time of rescue, and it's God's plan of rescue for you. Because not everybody will go in the escape of the bride. Not everybody is perfect. And there are other people who have to stay because they have to do work for the Lord, who have agreed to stay, to remain, to bring in the great harvest at Mount Zion. You might be part of this group, of the harvest workers. So then you have agreed to it. You will never go in the escape of the bride because you have to stay. You have to bring in the harvest. You have to create the assemblies of love and righteousness in the nations. And you have to gather the people with the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit. So if you have agreed to this one, pray over it. Ask the Lord if you will remain. And if you will remain, then please come together, join us. Bring the societies of the Rose forth into the nation so that we can gather the people, that we can walk with them towards Mount Zion. Because the rapture into paradise will take place at Mount Zion, the mountain that is carved not with human hands, but is carved and created by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And it will appear and everybody will see it at the sixth seal. The escape is a sudden thing. The escape of the bride, nobody will see Jesus or the angels or anything. The people will just disappear. But at the rapture into paradise, at the sixth seal, the whole world will see our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ appearing. He will come and he will take the multitude of his people to him and to the Father, because the Father throne of glory will be on top of Mount Zion. So join us. This is not a joke, and this is not made for entertainment. This video series that we produce is for you a wake-up call to come out of your life and lay your heart at the feet of the Father and you walk with us towards him so that you can be raptured into paradise. So please join us. Join Triple Grace. Join the Societies of the Rose or establish one in your neighborhood. We are calling to Satan, to the snake, to dragon, let my people go. And the people will go. They will come out of the world. I thank you that you are here with me for this part. And do not forget, the next biblical plague that will come up will be this one of darkness. Remember my words when you will see it. And be ready to walk out of the world in Babylon anytime. Pack your bags. Break camp. We are ready to go. Join us. Because the escape of the bride is shortly. And then we must walk. We must come out. And we must do the work, the daily sacrifice of love that the Lord has described for us. To walk as he did, to act as he did, and to talk as he did. To gather in the people. As the apostles did after the Lake of Tiberias, after they have received in Jerusalem at Pentecost the Holy Spirit. We will be prepared and all resources will be given to us. The Lord will take us under his wings and we will fulfill our destiny and purpose in this world to snatch as many pearls from the dragon as we can and to bring them to Mount Zion. I love you all dearly. And I hope that you will all join me and come together and walk this exciting path towards Mount Zion and to bring as many people to righteousness as you can. Read Daniel 12:3. And then you will shine forth as the stars in heaven. Thank you all. My name is Michael and I will see you again in our next video. May God bless you and your family abundantly. Maranatha.